Hi, everybody. This is Randy Suits with a letter and a song. Our letter for 16 May is I Write Our Words. My darling Eve, it is easy to pen letters to you, my darling. And it's even more pleasing reaching out to you in short messages which echo and resonate within my body, mind, and soul. Because the essence of all the thoughts therein contained spring from the multitude of dialogue, ideas, plans, and dreams we create. They are living and life-giving epistles of faith and trust in all that we ever had, now possess, and ever will know together. They are living because they issue forth in real time, responsive to the moment-by-moment changes and variances of our lives as one and as individuals. As individuals, because the elasticity of the love God gave us stimulates our self-worth without diminishing our personal autonomy. We are free to be ourselves, and yet we are always one in devotion, cleaving to each other while aligning our personal wills with God first, and then with one another. Our love assures and ensures that we do our utmost to protect, preserve, and protect the absolute best for the fidelity of our union and investment in God's plan for each other. These principles and issues of life are life-giving, for our spirits feed upon the hope, objects, and accomplishments to secure the present and build the future. In fact, I write our words when my heart calls out to you in letters. Because I have you and you have me, I write our words to express my deep affection to you, my life love, calling out to you in spirit and in script, your Kohane. And that's what we do. Love grows stronger as the days pass. It grows deeper and more godly, more godlike, as we include God in the midst of our relationship and center our love for each other in the Most High God and His Son, Jesus Christ. Now we're going to do a song called Living on Love. Two young people without a thing say some vows and spread their wings, settle down just what they need, living on. She don't care about what's in style, she just likes the way he smiles. It takes more than marble and tile, living on love. Living on love, buying on time, without somebody nothing ain't worth a dime. Just like an old-fashioned storybook rhyme, living on love. It sounds simple, that's what you're thinking. But love can walk through fire without blinking. It doesn't take much when you get enough, living on love. Two old people without a thing, children gone but still they sing, side by side on that front porch swing, living on love. He can't see anymore, she can barely sweep the floor. Hand in hand they walk living on love, buying on time. Without somebody, nothing ain't worth a dime. Just like an old-fashioned storybook rhyme, living on love. It sounds simple, that's what you're thinking. Love can walk through fire without blinking. It doesn't take much when you get enough, living on love. Living on love, buying on time. Without somebody, nothing ain't worth a dime. Just like an old-fashioned storybook rhyme, living on love. It sounds simple, that's what you're thinking. But love can walk through fire without blinking. It doesn't take much when you get enough, living on love. No, it doesn't take much when you get enough, just living on love. And that's what we do, isn't it? We live on love. We live in love because we are all those things that love makes us one to another. And so now, my dear friends, may the Lord, even the Most High God, be with you in all that you think, say, do, and are. Thank you for being, and God willing, we'll see you again soon.